As I get older, I really do see like a lot of my mother in me. As much as she was like really strict and like heavy-handed, she's also really funny, and she was very like, when she was feeling affectionate, she just lavished you with love. And my mom had been becoming unwell. She was tired all the time. She would sleep all day, go to work, and then come back and sleep all day. And I thought that it was probably an emotional problem, like she was depressed or something. She stopped eating, she'd be bedridden for days, she was just very down. She was taking medication for something, but she had an allergic reaction to it, so she swelled up. So I got a call from my aunt, my mom's sister, and she was like, Sam, we booked your plane ticket, you have to come home. And so I get home, and my aunt and my uncle, my mom's brother, pick me up. And we get to the car, and my uncle is very like somber, and he's like, Sam, you know, your mom is a very spiritual, religious, Christian person, yes. And even now your mom's with the Lord. One of them was like, umawako araseko, and that's basically saying your mom is no longer here. Obviously, it's like a very painful experience. I was disappointed, especially because my relationship with my mother was very turbulent. And I felt like as I got older, we would like come to understand each other and develop a better relationship, but I didn't really get the chance to get there. Obviously, that was one of the really disappointing parts about my mom passing away. Just like, life is not altogether horrible. There some really, really great things about it, and I think my goal is to increase those things and let them take over and just find a way to deal with things that are out of our control that just happen to really, really suck.